Hey guys, welcome to our special video here where we're going to be covering some highlights from the West Plains Model Railroad Club's October display. It's going to have some really cool stuff in it. It's going to feature, of course, the HO layout, the large one, as well as the smaller layout. Also, the condensed version of the O scale layout. During the time I was there, they had an S scale train with some really cool locomotives that you're going to see right off the bat, in this, first segment of the video. So, if you're like me, you're especially a fan of the Frisco, I think you're really going to like this one. Just as a side note there, but anyway, we hope you guys enjoy this, kind of extended highlight show a little bit, some nice spring train action. So, kick back, relax, and enjoy the trains. Alright, so we're starting here looking at the Lionel American Flyer 484, number 4500, with and they're putting some passenger cars on. Yeah. And who'd you say the passenger cars were made by again?
These?
Yeah.
American Models.
American Models, okay.
But they're about to go belly up entirely. They were anti-vax folks.
Oh, yeah?
And he got Rona kissed him and he died.
Huh.
And she's not even making an effort. She's just selling out the stock for that, and I don't think they're going to stay in business.
That's a shame.
Yeah, it is.
Really. Those are really nice looking cars.
Oh, yeah. Did that, too. Well, I didn't do that. And they go
pretty near perfect with that engine.
Oh yeah, the blue is a little too dark.
Yeah,
but that's typical American models. They never quite get their color right. Like Frisco painted their diesels and whatnot,
yeah,
in a mandarin orange and white scheme.
Right.
And when S. Helper made Frisco yard slippers,
yeah,
they painted them red and white. Well, they weren't.
I'm going to come around there where I can get a better shot of those cars.
S. Helper made them.
I guess I should ask you if it was all right if I filmed them.
Oh, yeah. Huh?
That is really nice.
It's the first time it's been run. Okay. Need to back them up a little. There, you want to put that one on?
I got it.
This one doesn't appear to light up. It's an express car, so it may not. It's a mail car. May belong behind the express car. Express cars where all the money and stuff is.
Yeah.
And these are the ones
now,
that the train robbers always try to get hold of.
Now, what would these cars run on this hill, just relatively price-wise?
You know, I don't remember. It's a long ago I bought them, I have forgotten.
Because I know the 484 is like either side of $1,000. I think. Maybe more than that. It looks good.
When I was a kid, once we got them running with the lights on,
yeah,
we turn off all the house lights and just
yeah.
Watch them going on.
Oh yeah, that's always the best. You got a car derailed. The baggage car is derailed.
Which one? Oh, the one right behind.
Yeah,
right
the one right behind the engine. That's probably why it's hiccuping when it's running.
Yeah. I'm more of a car because it's not so. You ready?
Yep, there goes another one. I got it.
Let's put that on the go.
Get on. Yeah, that will. I probably screwed him up.
There it is. Okay. Yeah.
Now, are you going to set your S gauge up at Christmas?
Yep. How far away can you stay in the remote work?
I don't know.
Well,
is it boogered up?
The axle's not in there, by the way.
Well, the axle came loose?
The axle just popped down in there.
Oh, okay. No crap. I bet it was packed that way. What do you bet?
Probably.
Well, the bell's pretty good.
Sounds good.
Nah, that's just too anemic. I mean, you can hear these guys across half the county, usually. The real ones?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I know Ed Burke one.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
I think it's sound units.
Huh?
I think it's the sound unit, maybe.
Yeah, something's
going on. Yeah, something's going on because your control's flashing.
Track
was it?
Track
might be great. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Look at that. Uh-oh. It's got a bad spot right there. Derailed. That's where it derailed before, too.
Yeah. Something may be binding that car up, keeping the trucks from turning.
Well, that's true, too. It's the first time these cars have been run, so there's no telling what's going on. These are all made in China and shipped into S Helper. So there's no telling.
These are also very long, and this is kind of great. This comes into a grade right here.
Yeah.
I got a wedge under here to keep these cables level, so them being that long and going over that sharp of a curve like that.
That may be lifting it up a little bit.
Maybe a problem.
Well, anyway, we know it runs.
Good looking engine.
Oh, it's good. I just wish the color on the cars was a little bit better now. Lionel, this is what Lionel is doing for American Flyer now.
Yeah.
It's called Flyer Chief.
Yeah.
Comes with the controllers. It's not nearly as advanced as their O-Gage stuff.
Yeah.
But it's still, you know, it's better than the original American Flyer.
I wish they did an engine like this in HO still.
Well, they do.
Who doesn't?
Well,
that's not brass. I mean,
no, it's.
I know Broadway Limited Imports has a
485. They make scale engines in HO just as good as this one, don't they? Or better.
Yeah.
Now, what I was talking about was this particular engine.
Oh, the Meteor?
Yeah, the Meteor.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Yeah, I wasn't talking about that, because I know they make really good steam engines.
Did K-Line ever do a Meteor? I know they did a Texas Special in O-Gage.
In O-Gage, I'm sure they did. Yeah. I'd be surprised if they did. They made a lot of
changes.
They never buried
what, K-Line? K-Line. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
They had one of the, remember that train shop that was open for a while up there on Battlefield,
yeah.
In Springfield?
Yeah.
You know, he died pretty early, and then he literally died, and I think left his Memphis for a mountain of debt. So, I mean, she was trying to sell the business, and I remember she was sitting in there, poor woman. And she had a really stressed look on her face. She didn't know how to cope with it. No, no. That was the guy, they had a shop there for years and years. That was called Trainline.
Maybe it helped with the tracks clean.
Yeah.
And they were on,
I was going to bring my track clean car for that HO.
And that was a good place to go.
I've got a power one.
Yeah, for American Flyer.
Yeah, it seems like everything's running good right now, so.
Yeah, just watch the drivers on this thing. Every now and then,
yeah.
Set a nut or a bolt, and you'll need to find it.
Yeah.
I'm going to Loctite them in one of these days. Yeah, we'll just keep it at that slow speed and see what happens.
Yeah.
I need to get some little figures to go on that observation deck at the end of the car. A couple guys sitting out there with their feet up, you know, seat up.
Yeah.
Or something. Huh?
Again.
It jumps off right there.
Those cars may just be too long for the curves.
That's what I'm thinking. I think
that's a distinct possibility. Usually on the box, they'll tell you what radius curve they use.
I think that's just too sharp a curve for everything.
Yeah, because they do hang off quite a bit.
Yeah. And the center of gravity just pulling them in. So
these are high rail, 70-foot heavyweights. Well, 72-foot heavyweight, according to the sticker.
Yeah.
There should be another one here somewhere. Let's see what this is.
Hey, try and run in the lap with just these.
Okay.
This car seems to follow.
You want me to try it and see what it does?
No, slowly.
Just derailed.
Yeah. top, curved track to rail mesh.
It's right there. Yeah.
It's only the first part.
There's a ridge right there. I can see it. No. It tells you how to modify the truck if it's doing that.
I think I'll just, if I ever get around to finishing up a layout, I think I'll just put wider radius curves on it and see if that solves it.
Yeah.
Well, we know
that.
If you
keep running the engine, that's fine.
Let's put that one away in the box.
Well, I appreciate you bringing that out and showing it.
Well, thank you. Oh, wait, what?
That's nice.
Yeah. Well, yeah, if you were toasted, you know, I'm just telling you to pay attention.
I know, because if one year you don't have the plastic, the good thing for it will come to the market.
Sometimes I don't know. It's an Indy River Big Two.
But
is it called the S1?
That probably doesn't apply to the model.
It's
still the same mechanism as the other.
The trucks. Sandy River. The trucks want to pop off the track and switch us.
They pop off.
Well, if you got a track with those switches.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I
that, guys. That was a tour of the West Plains Model Railroad Club's 2023 edition of the October display. There's still one more weekend left coming up this next Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Of course, Thursday and Friday, they'll be open from 2 to 6 p.m. And then Saturday and Sunday is noon to 5. So if you get a chance to stop by this weekend, do so. You never know. You might see me there one day. So, yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And by the way, if you can't make it for the October display, the Christmas display is coming up right around the corner in December. So we've now got our operating hours on that. We'll do a video on that later on down the road. So stay tuned for that one. So like I said, hope you guys enjoyed the video. We'll catch you guys on down the line. Take care, all. Bye for now.